इंडियन सोल्जर, इंडियन वुमन सोल्जर, वेरी गुड सोल्जर, वेरी गुड सोल्जर. दैट वाज द फर्स्ट टाइम दे एक्नॉलेज दैट वी वर सोल्जर्स एंड दैट वी हैड एनी राइट टू बी. He was very particular. Whenever he used to see me, he said, your uniform is not ironed. So I said, but in camp, we haven't got an iron. So then he called his orderly, Kundan Singh, ek jodi kapda kaptan saab ke liye taiyar rakhna hai. Jab aayenge aur hamara saath kahin jana hai, wo dena hai unko. I had been working in a hospital for disabled people. So that was right in the middle of the jungle, and we thought that we couldn't be seen by the air. And there had never been any fighting there because it was not on any strategic point at all. But Netaji visited the hospital, and there were so many spies, they were out to get him. So the very next day, our hospital was completely bombed. And many of our patients died because they couldn't get out even and get into a trench. We decided first to go into the still interior of Burma. There was a lake there called Inle Lake, and stay there as long as we could or till the war was over. The second night, at about 4 o'clock in the morning, I was woken up by a bayonet pointing to me, and I looked and I saw a Japanese soldier with a bayonet, and they tied us on trees, each one, and they said they'll go to their officer and find out what has to be done to us. So we were sure now this is the end. Then one officer came, and he had a newspaper in his hand, and he was looking at the newspaper, then he was looking at me, then he came right up and he kept the newspaper next to me and said, looked at me, and he went on and on like this. Then finally this man had us released. So we moved further into the jungle and we built our own hut there, and while we were there we were captured by the British, and then they took me to their headquarters, the Force 136, this was. And we were made prisoners. But what prisoners of war? Because they were also a guerrilla group, and they didn't have any prison or guard or anything. So they said, since you're a doctor, you can also help us here in the dispensary. This mass euphoria and hysteria used to upset me very much, because I felt they really didn't understand what it was all about and what it meant towards the freedom of India, and just having heroes and heroines. So I used to really shy away from the crowds, because after a few days in Delhi, I came away to Madras, and that's when I saw the condition which our ex-INA people were, and I decided at least to see somehow to rehabilitate them. Soldiers, when they were being trained in bayonet fighting, they used to say, "Maro dekho kicho," you know. That is, you maro, that them, and then you kicho, and then you take it out. So, whereas these other North Indian troops, you know, the Musalman used to say, "Allahu Akbar," when they charge, and the others say, "Jai Hanuman" or "Jai Ramji ki." But the South Indians say, "Maro dekho kicho, maro dekho kicho," when they were going into battle. And but they were very effective, so they really won the admiration of all the other. Netaji says, there's no such thing as martial or non-martial. It all depends on the training and the motivation. And I'm giving them both. I'll give them whatever training is available here, they will be given equally, and motivation is the freedom of India. But it's a very great pity that this achievement by the INA, and especially of these civilian volunteers, is not being recognized at all. People in South India especially don't even know about it. So I hope somehow that now